have the honor to introduce our next speaker, Viola. She's organizing different kinds of festivals here in the Netherlands. For example, the GOGBOT Festival. I'm not really sure how to pronounce it. You can see that video in the background. And her big topic is building bridges between professional arts, hacking, and activism. So that's really exciting. And also, I'm sure you've seen those big monsters over there. So I guess that's why some of you are here. They look really fancy and cool. So I'm not really sure what's going to happen during this talk. I've heard many things, sounds really exciting. So I'm just going to give it to Viola. Please give her a warm welcome. Nice round of applause.
Hello. I heard that in this back site there is a building up now of an fireworks that will start at 12. So it might be that I quiet when they make loud sounds. In the background you see a video of GOGBOT. That's one of the festivals that I organized for 7 years. And I think I'll wait a bit before the things are over. It's easier. I think that the sound is stopped in the back, I hope, and if not, we'll just go on. So my presentation, let me open it. It's going to be a little bit interactive, so that means if you're bored, please tell me, then I can change it, or when you want to hear a special thing about one of the topics. So the three main topics are called robots, art, and activism. So, if you want to hear more about robots, please just... I know it's difficult when you're an audience, you never make any sounds, and you're always afraid to raise your hand. I know how it is to sit there. I feel really pity for you, because I can do it with you whatever I like, so it's a tough position, I know it is. But if you really want to hear more about robots, try to... get this over, yes? Good. And that also counts for art and activism. So, because I have a lot of options in this talk. So, one of the things you can do here all this day is this exoskeleton which Frierik Wieringa made, and he's standing over there. And you can actually put it on, like he's doing on the picture here, and when he moves his limbs, the exoskeleton also moves. And one of the things that I would like to achieve is that I would like to build more bridges between the hacker scene and the tech people and the artists, because I think that you can even create cooler stuff like this as long as you want it. So that's one of the main underlying topics that I have in my talk. Oh, this is a bit of a mess. It's what I did before. This is some of the partners I had the last years. This is a big event coming up. Yeah, I'm first to the official boring title stuff. Now, this is the title of one of the things that I'm now doing. It's called Manifestations. It's during Dutch Design Week in Eindhoven, because the thing is, they get 290,000 visitors there that week in Eindhoven. So if I want to tell anything to the world, like about privacy or about activism, 290,000 possible visitors. It's a really good thing. And we also won last year an award, Best of the Dutch Design Week. I did in 2001, Pioneering in the Cave in Amsterdam, in the Chamber of Academic Calculations. They had a VR cave. We did the first theater play in. And then in 2010, I did an invasion in the MoMA. I don't know if you know what it is. It's the Museum of Modern Art. It's in New York. They have all this really super beautiful art. And one day, Banksy, oh, that's the Tesla girls. Banksy, it's also a hacking, put his own art there because he was thinking, well, I want my own art there and I hate this hierarchical system, so I just take a hammer and a nail and I just put it up. So this is a similar thing that we did with AR, because like the radio frequencies, we also own, we the people, we also own the virtual layers that we have over the current ones. So you could use this layer app, which you could download, and then in every physical geolocation, you could add your own app. So we added our own 3D artworks, and here you see, it's a bit small. It's the opening speech of a science fiction author called Bruce Sterling, who's one of the biggest science fiction authors in the world and loves media art. And he was actually opening this hacking into the MoMA exhibition. And the MoMA, they were not angry at all, and they were not pissed off. They just put this on the official program. So hacking yourself into stuff works, because sometimes they like it and they put you on the program. I'll skip some slides because it's going to be really thousands of slides. So what I see is, like, for instance, this is a theater group called Crew, and they were creating the Oculus Rift 15 years before it existed. So a lot of artists are really, like, with an engineering background, or they're really interested in new AR and VR and perception. Scientific research and how it works. So they just build their own tech stuff before it becomes mainstream. And I think it's really cool. So you had a helmet on with a 360 camera on your head, and you had video goggles on and a really heavy laptop on your back with a heavy battery pack. And then you were taken through this theater play, which was a psychiatric hospital. And some parts were real, and then suddenly you saw ghosts floating up, and you thought, okay, this might have been pre-recorded, and people holding your hands, so you all thought it was really real. Is the audio good, by the way? Because I'm not sure if it's okay. Yeah? Super. Now, and another thing is what they also found out is, if you put people like this headset on, like them, let them see this virtual world, but you often, like the stage, you only have a limited space. But if you make it round, you can make people think that they're endlessly walking straight, because when you show them a straight wall or a straight line all the time, in the physical world, there's a little curve in this wall. You can use this trick by making them think that they're endlessly walking straight. And there's a lot of things happening now with holograms and holodeck cafes, and I'm super annoyed myself by what the broad audience then gets to see is the Samsung demos, yeah, because it's nice for one time, but it's also interesting to like work on new experiences and things that don't exist. So one of the things that I always do with my festivals is that I always wonder what role do we actually want technology to play in the future. So I wanted to actually think about democratizing technology. Technology has influence nowadays on us all. And one of the things that I did is there was in Berlin last year, there was a big exhibition of technical tech and HKW, and it was called Nervous Systems, and I made an homage to it with crypto fingernails, explaining to a really big audience then what crypto is, because crypto and passwords are for a lot of people really like abstract things. So you have to change your password every couple of months, and it has to have 10 digits, and it's really annoying, and you get tired. But if you make this into a ritual, then it gets more interesting. So this, why does one screen? Okay, I think I have to make this smaller. No. Small R. Why doesn't it disappear? Oh. No. No. Okay, I will show you the thing after this. And then one of the other things that I found is that there's a lot of nervous systems in the world. Like this is an actual facial recognition app, and it is actually used in the Mediterranean areas, and it's just software, and it identifies people walking in the street, and it gives them tags, like profile tags. So if you have a high forehead, you're being tagged as having a high IQ, but if you are a little bit beardy, you're terrorized, yes, as a categorized as a terrorist, and that's a category that you don't want. And then technical tech has a lot of videos also, like, yeah, because a lot of people think they have nothing to hide, and we like using Google Maps, and we like using Google because it's easy. And then, yeah, but I always say that I have a lot of games on, and also use Google Maps, but Google, it's not a philanthropic, nice company that just gives you these apps, because in the end there's always someone paying for these apps, and that is you, that is the consumer, either by that your ticket prices are getting higher, or that you get more police checks, or that you have other health insurance raising costs, and a lot of people don't know this. So what I do is also that I work with a lot of artists that actually work with these topics. Okay, now it's now time to really show you these things. I'm going to shut down the PowerPoint. Then it should start. Come to the right. Yes, that's what happened. Okay. So here you see the wheel with the password club, where you could generate a passwords and in the end get all the 10 things on your nails, and it made it a bit like a QR styling, so they were encrypted in a way that not everybody could see your passwords. So she's making like a V shape, but then she also puts a lot of digits around it that you can see that it was a V, but other people don't. And this is another work called Tinder In. That's about, on one hand, you see a picture from LinkedIn, and on the other hand, Tinder, because people think that they're on LinkedIn, they wear a tie, and on Tinder, they wear this sexy outfit, and they have no idea that it's easy to find both of these profile pictures easy with each other. And this is a guy that's called Leonardo Salvaggio, and he has created masks from his own face, and he really wants to screw up all these facial recognition databases. So he thinks that if he just spreads all these masks to the world, and if everybody wears them, then these databases could get confused and less reliable. And it's also an interesting way to explain to an audience how it works. And another thing that I've been working on is an exhibition called Internet of Women Things. I will show you a video of this. It's about that women have like different needs from tech. For instance, this work was about what would happen if we would just from a tech perspective look on the world and on how we could make our babies better prepared to the world in the future. So this one has, because of global warming, cooling ribs, that it could more easily cool the brains down. And another one had more bigger cheeks, so that it could get more caffeine intake when it drinks coffee, like here. And it's actually, it actually makes people think, like, if you just let technology go, is this the future that you want? And these images really, really stick with people. So this is about when you get a bit older and you lose some urine drops, you can also still look pretty and have this lace thicker underwear, so you don't have to wear this ugly old ladies wear. This is on the girl that did biohacking. She hated those plastic hygiene pads, and she said we can make them ourselves with lactobacillus, with milk bacteria. And to keep your flora healthy. And she just explains it, because we should share this knowledge and not only buy. This is another project of people really being sad that kids in China go through all the smog to the schools. And they made this plant that cleans the air, so they always have cleaned air in their lungs. And when they get to school, they just put the plant out and they put it on their table, and they also have cleaner air in the school. And then this is about wearables. So lots of women that I was teaching at Creative Technology at the University of Twente were also into wearables, like the wearable baby monitor that you could live see if your child was still alive or doing well, because if you have stress and it's not, and you want to go to the doctor, and then it's not good for the baby. This is a smart zipper, and it closes by itself, because often I have the stress that I cannot close. And then it's really nice that you have this woman again that thought, like, make it into a robot dress that closes by itself. So it's great for women, but also for older people or ill people. So it's more focused on helping us. A massage coat. Bruce Sterling with Jasmina Tesanovic also wrote text on the Internet of Women Things, that he wanted that he want more positive inclusive forms of IoT. We'll go a bit quicker to it, because then we can go to the robots, which are also super cool. And women are the most world's biggest oppressed group, because I also found out a lot of men, they have just their mobile phone numbers on the internet, and women often don't. So I thought, hey, that is also a big difference we should take into account. This was called smell dating. You can just date not on pictures, but on smell, if you like a t-shirt of a person. This is a smart tattoo that you can use as a trackpad or as other feedback. This is the smart meal, because women can often multitask, but when they cook, they have like dirty hands, or when they're in a meeting and they want to quickly answer a text message that they got, when they get their phone out, everybody thinks, oh, she's not interested in the talk anymore, that it's really rude. But if you like secretly do it with your nail, then it's fine, eh? So, oh yeah, here, when the hands are busy, but cooking is also really stereotyping, so I hated putting all these stereotyping things. Oh yeah, the 3D food printing, because athletes have different food needs than pregnant women. Fashion on brainwaves that also measure the outside air pollution or temperature, and then adapt to how you feel or you want to dress. And it's like an open concept, so you can just join. And now it's time for the pictures. If I can find the mouse. Robots. I hate extended desktops. This is like an industrial robot. Yes, good, super. Yeah, fixed. Okay, so this is an industry robot which they hacked, and it gave a new purpose, so it could actually turn tables, so it could be a DJ, which was really interesting, because you can actually do it too. You just go to a industrial area where they have these things, or where you think that they might know people that know where they might have these things. So you cannot find these things on eBay, and you also cannot find these things on Amazon.com. I know a lot of hardware lovers love to look on the internet to find this stuff. This, the coolest stuff, you have to actually physically leave your house and actually ask around to actually find this stuff. But then when you have it, you can give it multiple purposes. Like here, this is all records here that were on sticks, and then the DJs in the middle, they were giving an awesome DJ show. All right, this is Frederik again, and there were a lot of robot builders. This was about the singularity, what would happen if technology takes over and enslaves us as their drones. Robot fire-spitting dogs. This is also work of Frederik Wieringa, who is standing there. He has a lot of bigger robots. This is a tracking wheel that could follow you in the streets. This woman on the left, she was actually here dancing in it, and it was following her like this creature that reacted on her. It was in the, this is GOGBOT. It was in the middle of the city in Enschede. So the people from all over the place, they just had to see this spectacle. So we put robots in, but we also put this activist art in that was teaching people, yeah, what to think of tech. So on one hand, they were more interested in tech, because it was even like a local farmers came, and kids and really old people, because they were curious in the spectacle that we had. So we didn't, because people don't visit, not all people visit museums anymore. So if you just take the art out, put it in the street, offer a multi-layered program of spectacular robot stuff, video stuff, and content also, that makes people think about the role that you want tech to have in the future and not. That really was a big success. Another cool one, this is called Titan, and it actually did comedy. It was also a lot of fun, people loved that. Here it is again. Oh yeah, again the robot dog that spits fire. This is Kurzweil with his theories about singularity. And we like spaceships, so we also build that. With scaffolding, this is electric fish. Gen pets, what could happen when we play more with gens, genetics. It's a crew. Crew also experimented not only with theater, but also like seeing what the other person sees or swapping genders. And this is like 15 years ago, because I see now a lot of these VR startups, and they're all just discovering the same things. They're now inventing the wheel that we actually did in the 90s with VR in the art scene. So I hope they would learn from the experiences that we had and not start over again. I'm just showing a lot of cool pictures now, according to my... The singularity is near, resistance is future. That was a topic that we also discussed, like, is this... Is it true? Will tech outsmarten us? Does it have limits? Do we need to guard against it? What do we do? Do we need to all learn to program? Do we want all the power at Google? Do we want to share it? Should we also learn how to create this? This is also this is a performance group that also showed what happens when tech would take over the world. This is Stellark. He was the first one in the 80s that was doing bionic art, like building an ear in his arm and adding extra arms that he actually used. There are nowadays this is a hot topic. You can actually buy an extra finger that actually works. So if you're a technician that could use like 11 or 12 fingers, you can just buy it now. I think it's on AliExpress or so, but it's really fun. You can just use that stuff now. Okay, I'm going a bit quicker than I expected. Nice. Activism. GOGBOT again. This is the market square where you can... this boy had an... you could press this interface, I have an arrow here, and you could, that would give him an electric pulse to his arm or his knee, and he would shake because he would actually get this pulse. And another slider you could choose if you wanted it like really strong or not strong at all, and then everybody chose really strong, and the guy was in terrible pains all the day, but people really loved that, having their own avatar, real life avatar. And we have a lot of criticism on IBM and Shell and art, and we also explain that in the artworks. A lot with sustainability and recycling of big products. Controversial art about jihad and ISIS. This one, this is from Herwig Weiser, taking the space sounds out of the earth, and in the back you will see a video game where you could actually drive this car, but they hacked out a gravity code, so it was not on the ground anymore, but it was just flying around everywhere. And this was about the power of Google, because often journalists, often when they do research, they only read like the first or the second page of Google, and it's not smart because you don't always get the most accurate answers, because you always get the most popular ones or what Google decides to show you. So the word riots here is here put in four different languages, and you see that riots in one country that's more about football or about fires or political riots. So it's also, artists try to actually show to this broad audience if it's, that they should know that, what danger Google actually has. Show more pictures. Yeah, you can also say stop or if you want to have some a bit more explained. This is an open source project about laser graffiti, because when you put real graffiti on a building, then you have to wash it off again, and it costs money. But if you have a really big beamer and a laser pen, you can just draw with software on the building and then write your message to the world. And then as long as the beamer is on, you can always see it still. So it's a great way if you have like this beamer on your fan to do everywhere temporarily graffiti messages, and it's open source.
Is it legal?
Yeah, it's legal. You can just put it everywhere because you're not damaging anything, I think, because I don't think there are actually laws made out of this, but I never heard there was a problem with it. So it's another way to hack the law or to go around things. This is one of the, this is also like 10 years ago, this guy had also movements and he wanted to have a cool thing like Frierk has here. So he had like laser beams following the positions of the arms of the visitor that you had on. So there was also this robot controlling feeling, but it was not still like this. This was the, oh yeah, in Baghdad there were some car bombings, huh? So they put like bombs on the cars and they really blew up. But that's the thing that you always read in the news, and then it sounds really like, oh, that's Baghdad, that's normal there. But then we had car wrecks actually on the market square, and then the people were, they were grossed out, they were super shocked and they hated it, and the festival got a negative quote that year, and it was like too yeah, bad, and we were super happy because finally the people saw that it was yeah, that it's not only a thing from news, but that it's real. So that's also sort of activism. We had a topic about internet memes, bio industry. This was about metal art, also about the aesthetics of evil, because a lot of art can also be fun. So we had this microphone and you could scream in it, and then it would like put this grunt out, like yeah, you know, like metal music, and you could put a guitar on, and the kids, they were like screaming as loud as they could, and there was this super heavy grunt coming out, and the floor was actually filled with beer cups, and in the end it was really like also drinking beer, and it was everywhere. Yeah, even the beer was some kind of art form, because artists nowadays, they don't play anymore with clay or with paint or with stone, but they also, yeah, play with the internet and with tech, but also with beer and with beer herbs. All right, this is Dave Blank, is the head of the nanotech lab, and even the pictures that he actually made and the pictures from biology, we were also playing with it as art. Do you know a thing called DNA origami? That's on a micro scale. You can actually look it up. It's really geeky also, DNA origami, and then you can do like this little super microscope art things with that. And a lot of people loved it, but often it was loud, and some of the people really didn't like it anymore, like these ones, but they still wanted to watch because they were curious to what strange stuff you were showing again. See, they look totally unhappy. I like that. And we did a lot of workshops with the kids also. We heard from the people in Amsterdam that we were the only place where we were actually encouraging kids to take all kind of old telephones and televisions and then smash them onto the stones as hard as possible to crush them, take them open, disassemble them, and then make them into Zelda wings or other creative robot parts. So they could create little robots and games like this one. Create their own toys. This is another spaceship. This is a movie called Daughter of a Terrorist, because a lot of terrorists just don't shoot for fun, but they have a reason why, because often they have a history where their child or their wife got hurt or killed, and that is a terrorist don't shoot without a reason. The world is not black and white, so the video showed this daughter crying and bleeding, and it was called Daughter of a Terrorist, to like show again that it's not like black and white, and the news is not only like this and that, but it always has a why question before people do things. And this is about gay activism in Second Life, because in Iran there were two gay teenagers killed because they were gay, and it is not allowed in Iran, so the government killed them, teenagers, and then they let it rain pink crosses in Second Amsterdam, and they made a lot of other art there. And we showed that in Amsterdam and a lot of other places in the world. And on the Second Life there was also a bit also a big cyberpunk scene, because there was going to be a censorship on Second Life, and we wanted this free world, not with McDonald's and big capital, but more like the internet was in the beginning times. Okay, next. This is about round architecture. It's called Architects of Air. It's like this blow-up architecture with balloons. This is an artist group called Association of Autonomous Astronauts, because until now rockets were only put into space by big countries like the US and Russia. And then we thought, well, we can also try it. So we just start groups and try to shoot things into space and become do-it-yourself astronauts. Hacking road sign boards. Well, you know, when you have a traffic jam or whatever, you always see these road signs. So we also hack those. This is about air purifier on a city scale. So in your house you can have like this anti-smog machine, like an ionizer, but you can also build this for a whole town. Or this is Dan Roosgaarde's work, like a car that would charge himself on a smart way, highway, or a highway with pictograms when it's slippery, the road. And soldering classes and experimental music and glitch sounds. This is a body suit, and when this guy moves, he orchestrates his own music piece. So when he stretches his arm, there's another sound, and when he moves his head, and it's also a nice way of creating new instruments. This was an activist thing. I don't know if you heard of Femen, the activist group with half naked women. You probably did. I see two people say yes. Okay. You are afraid. I told you this. That's good. So these women knew that if you put banners on, that nobody listens anymore. So they put it on their breasts, and it went viral. It went all over the internet, and it sold magazines, so it was a really effective way of protesting. So at the time that Pussy Riot got arrested, do you know Pussy Riot? Yeah, they were singing the song against for freedom of speech and against Putin, because they didn't have that much freedom of speech in Russia, and they got sent to Siberia to a punishment camp. Then this woman, who's the head of Feynman. She was so pissed off, so she took a chainsaw and she cut down a Christian cross. She says, fuck this. Let those girls out because we are now angry, the women of the world. And she was in Kiev, and then the police wanted to kill her, so she jumped out of her balcony. And these women, they have these really short, yeah, this is hot pants of jeans on. So she only had her passport. And she went to Paris and she asked for asylum there, and she got a new passport there. And I heard about it. And a couple of days after that, she was in a bus to Enschede, and we cut together a couple of Christian crosses because I also had a chainsaw. And I thought, well, let's cut some crosses. And then I'm also nice with marketing, so it led to more than 1,000 newspaper articles from all over the world, like in Russia, in the Ukraine, in Armenia. We were all over the news. It was huge. But in Holland, we were on the Radio 1, and we were called by the Wereld Draait Door, but they didn't have time because it was the election time. So yeah, so it was in Germany in the news, in France also, in Poland, in the Ukraine, everywhere. And there were even articles saying that, yeah, they're in the back here, that they were now replacing the wooden crosses by steel crosses because of this new movement of topless Feynman activists cutting Christian crosses down, and they were really shitting their pants. And then even Medvedev also reacted to this protesting, and they actually thought because we did it twice that we would do it all over the world, but we only did it twice. But it was good that it led to a lot of it says also, this is a Google Translate page of a Russian news article, and It also went good over the internet. People were creating fan art. That's another thing again. Yeah, so using new tech and using the internet and knowing what also works makes you also help you making activism effective. This is about it is scan where you dance and then project it in the back. That it's interesting interaction with tech. I'm always hearing this background noise all the time. I don't know if you also hear it, but for me it doesn't help me to focus on the story that I want to tell. This is with brain scanners, like this is a copy of a work of Nam June Paik. So when a girl looks into the television screen here, she sees herself in this Buddha position, and when she focuses, then it's there, but if she's really stressed out, then it goes away again. So if she's focused and calm, then this Buddha image appears. And there were artists making games also reacting to how you would feel in your brain using brain scanners. Oh yeah, this was the ISIS work, but that was actually painted over by people that didn't like that work. Here, painted away because they. We also tried to get European money once, but we were late with the deadline. But we had this event with the topic of Europe, and I learned a lot about Frontex and about European borders, and also this guy, Teun Kastelein, he actually thought, like, what can I do for the $1,000 that I got here? And he thought, where is it sunny? So he went to Lampedusa and he saw all these boats, and he made like this also like a viral video about this, like, hey, you can order this boat now and it will look really hip in the Amsterdam canals. It's a really good party boat, just needs a little bit of love. As you can see, that it's kind of wrecked, and it comes from all the way from exotic Africa with original colors. Order now. And then after that, he actually, when the refugee crisis started, he actually took one of these boats to Amsterdam, and he had like canal tours, because in Amsterdam you can do canal tours, and he wanted to create an alternative canal tours where you could have dinner with refugees, and they would tell you about their travel, how they got to Europe. And it's really interesting to like hear a story like that, especially on a boat like that while you're doing a canal tour. Other partners, oh yeah, you just heard this story. More pictures. Oh. Oh yeah, this is a neighborhood in Scandinavia. It was called Superkillen, and it was in the problem area. Are we being hacked again? Almost. And then they just put paint everywhere, and they put symbols of this different cultures also everywhere, like a Moroccan fountain and things from all over the world. And suddenly the people felt more like public space was also for them, and they started to get to know each other better. And we had an event called GOGBOT, and with a team of Atompunk, and it was about just like steampunk, but then more about the 50s, when you could look back at the area of the 50s, where on one hand the man could suddenly go to the moon, so technology could give us new unlimited possibilities. Science fiction movies started, there was a lot of optimism, but on the other hand we had threat of the nuclear war. So we had like on one hand a positive feeling that energy was for free, and that we had nuclear energy, and it was endless, and it didn't cost any money to make, or hardly any money. But then the Cold War and the nuclear threat, and then there was a lot of ideologies also coming up. And we can learn a lot when we step a couple of steps back to learn about the future, when we see what ideologies we had before, or what ideas we actually had to learn, yeah, what we want with tech and what role we actually want tech to have and not. And at that time there was a lot of tech experiments, like megalomane airplanes like this one in Russia, because they're like super uber cool. And other artistic creations with space age design, age bombs. And also the history of the Dutch, it always looks really like this golden, it has this golden edge, huh? Like the golden ages, and then Rembrandt looks really like this wise older man, but actually, yeah, there are artists actually comparing them to Nazis and drugs dealers, because they always are portrayed like these super beings, but we also have criticism, like on the VOC, they were conquering the world, and they were not being really nice, so the Netherlands got really rich on yeah, other people's over the Dutch invented slavery. They also said the Dutch were the ones that sold the black people to America, because they thought it was closer than the tea that they had to get in Asia. So we were cruel, and the artists also want to show us that the history that we learn is not the one that you that you want to see, perhaps. Okay, well, the fire outside will start in a couple of minutes, probably 3 minutes. See? oh, yeah. So, if you have any questions.
Here. Yes. So. we're running out of time because out there there's a show that you don't want to miss and it's interfering with our talk too much anyway. So sadly, we don't really have time for Q&A. Oh, yeah.
Tomorrow at 7, there is at the other tent, there is a talk about hormones and hysteria that I give. It's also really interesting.
Yes, and so maybe later you can be over there with your robots
sure.
and answer some questions,
yeah.
because I'm sure there are some. This was a lot of information about the art scene and hacking, activism, how it all works together. So please give one more big
that
round
is okay.
of applause.
Don't do this. No, no.
That was a tough.
It's well, it is not me. It's the artist work that are creating this. I feel like I'm like showing off their stuff. So it's them, yeah?
Thank you.